Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In the previous video, you learnt about the various frame ranges that you use to display and navigate in the time bar. You can focus on specific segments using the result view, or you can expand the timeline range into the time bar and view the entire sequence through the contextual viewers. In short, you can work in and out of context in relation to the selected shots. In this video, we'll look at the three different storyboard modes, which enable you to see all the segments in your edit, but in a variety of different sorting. This does not limit any creative functionality, and you can continue to apply grading and effects to your edit. This video is not footage specific, so you can use your own media to follow along. Now, as a reminder, the storyboard modes are located to the right of the player controls, and the default setting is track mode. This is what you have been using throughout all the previous videos. Track mode means that you see one video track at a time, and all the thumbnails are in the order of the edit. Since the original selected segment was on video track 1, that is the current focus of the track mode and the storyboard. If you wish to change video tracks, you can just change it through the pull-down menu without having to return to the timeline. This is mapped to the page up and page down keyboard shortcuts. The storyboard will update, giving you the most accurate representation of all the segments on that video track to match the timeline. This includes gap segments, as well as muted or hidden shots. As an extra note, if a video track was locked in the sequence, it would not be available via the track pull-down menu. So in track mode, the storyboard reel gives you the representation of the various video tracks as you would see them in your editorial structure. Essentially, you are viewing your edit. This doesn't have much impact on the time bar, as you can still work with the segment range, media range, and timeline range of the sequence. However, sometimes in the context of grading or VFX, you may want to temporarily reorder the shots to help with certain tasks. Let's say you need to grade or affect a group of shots from the same tape and nearby source timecodes, but they are intercut with other shots in the edit. This happens all the time with all sorts of productions. So if you want to reorder the storyboard thumbnails based on their tape name and source timecode, you switch from track mode to sources mode. The storyboard updates, and a few things have changed. Firstly, the order of the thumbnails is rearranged by tape name and source timecode. If you alt-click on the first shot and move along to the right, you will be able to identify the common tape names and the ascending source timecode. In my case, the first bunch of shots come from the England tape with ascending source timecode, and the second bunch of shots come from the Japan tape, also with ascending source timecode. Now, if you have segments that have the same source timecode and tape name, the storyboard will use the timeline record timecode to choose which one appears first in the storyboard reel. Please be assured that the storyboard sorting is local to the effects environment. If you switch to the timeline, your edit is still perfectly intact. Coming back to the effects tab, the second point to mention is if you have a multi-video track edit using the sources mode sorting, all the video tracks get flattened into a single track, and each layer or segment is now a separate thumbnail in the storyboard reel. This gives you access to every source, regardless if they were part of a multi-layer composite or not. And since the segments are sorted by tape name and source timecode, gap segments, which are virtual segments, will not appear in the sources mode. As a side note, if you used the same source in multiple segments throughout the edit, each segment will still act as a separate shot, and you grade or affect them separately. If you wanted all the instances to have the same effects, you would either copy the timeline effects between multiple segments, or link the source using source segment connection prior to conforming the edit. Now, as a result of the storyboard sorting the thumbnails by tape and source timecode, the timeline range and the timeline contextual view, which is the primary track context, are now unavailable. If you click the options pull-down menu, you have the segment range, media range, and storyboard range. The storyboard range enables you to load the order of the shots in the time bar. And if you want to view, scrub, or play the shots in the order of the storyboard reel, click the View pull-down menu, choose Context, and select Storyboard Context. This is mapped as a toggle on the 4 keyboard shortcut. You can continue to work as normal, and you can switch between track mode and sources mode to suit your specific needs. Now, the third and final mode is known as the version mode. This can also be accessed through the pull-down menu. Similar to the sources mode, all the video tracks in the sequence are flattened into a single video track. But the main difference is instead of sorting by tape name and source timecode, the version mode sorts the thumbnails by the sequence's record timecode. So this will more or less match the original edit, but any segments used in a multi-layer composite will be placed one after the other. Usually it starts with the segment on the topmost track, followed by the segments underneath. So you won't get any more gaps in the storyboard reel, and you can see all the shots within the edit without changing tracks. As before, using the storyboard version mode, you have the segment range, media range, and storyboard range for the time bar, and you can use the storyboard context viewer to play and scrub the order of the shots. As soon as you switch back to the tracks mode, the timeline range and the primary track contextual view will become active again. Now, you may encounter an instance when the mode button is grayed out. This mainly happens if you have a gap segment set as your current selection. Just select a regular segment and the modes will become active again. As a final tip, with the storyboard getting longer using sources mode or version mode, or even if you have a very long timeline, a great keyboard shortcut to remember is Control Page Up or Control Page Down. This will allow you to navigate 10 thumbnails ahead instead of one at a time with the up arrow and down arrow keyboard shortcuts. So as a final recap, the track sorting mode shows all the segments in the storyboard reel in the order of the edit from the currently focused video track. The sources sorting mode flattens all the timeline segments onto a single track and sorts them by tape and source timecode. And finally, the version sorting mode also flattens all the timeline segments onto a single video track, but sorts them by the record timecode of the edit. So those are the three main sorting modes available for the storyboard. But as you will learn in the next video, you can focus the storyboard even further using storyboard filtering and searching. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to Flame 2019. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.